Good evening! Welcome to Life is Strange Before the Storm. So I was checking out the settings earlier. Look, the highest option is hella high. But yeah, so this is a prequel to Life is Strange, which is one of my favorite games really. Because it was a prequel, I actually kind of debated with myself whether I should do this or not, but in the end I decided to actually go back and play Life is Strange again. On my own time before I getting on this one. It was definitely great again, like just going through the whole story again. It was fun. So as far as I understand it, this is a prequel about Chloe during the years that Max, who is your character in Life is Strange, like during the years she was away. This is basically set during those years, is what I'm saying. So that should be fun, I think. I hope. Considering what state Chloe's in by the side of Life is Strange, maybe not. I guess that brings me to do something that I don't usually do, because I usually go in these completely blind, but content warnings. Yeah, so this game, at least Life is Strange, gets pretty dark. It deals with a lot of like real life issues, and that can be kind, you know, can mess some people up for understandable reasons. Some content warnings that come to mind for original Life is Strange, which may or may not apply to this one. I guess I would call it coded sexual violence, which was very unpleasant. Like death, which is a bit of a weird thing to warn people about in a video game, but it's like this one kind of treats the whole thing a lot more realistically and down to earth than normal, than most games, and like, yeah, the consequences of it and stuff, like, yeah, actually, like, some domestic violence was in original Life is Strange. What else? Oh, substance abuse. This game is fucked up. I don't know that it applies to Before the Storm. I know it applies to Life is Strange. Essentially what I'm saying is, tread with caution. You are the best judge of your own, of what is... what you can handle and what you can't, and if you can't handle it, then that's cool, you know, essentially. So I noticed the logo has changed, because like in Life is Strange this was actually like the IS was in a picture, and now it's got like the anarchy, eh? So well, this music is lovely. I think we should just jump in. Hold on, actually I'm gonna rearrange my windows a little, because... But yeah, this game is fucked up, and I know that in advance. I know that much in advance. Alright. So yeah. Let's start episode 1. Awake. Ooh, look at that. I like the bird. I'm actually wondering how this is gonna work, considering that we won't have time travel in this one, presumably. Well, we start with our first bad decision. Train is numbered 1327.
I can't believe Firewalk is playing a show at the old mill. Fuck yes.
So I did mention it.
Mom would kill me if she knew I was out here.
I didn't mention it yet, but I'm probably going to be kind of pretty quiet for this game. Just like, let the story play. So we don't have blue hair yet. It's going to take some getting used to. Actually, shit, hold on. I'm going to need to move my mouse over to the other side. So I'm gonna, which is where the mic is right now. We have a journal. Max, so you know how I stopped going to class so much? Like, you stopped talking to me so much? Funny story, I had trouble coming up with an excuse, so I just didn't set up, and it was fine. Nobody has said anything to me. Crazy, right? It's like I'm invincible all of a sudden. Maybe that's a perk of being a dad girl. No one knows what to do with me, so they're actually relieved when I stay home. Wish I'd figured this out sooner. Think of all the wasted school time. P.S. Chris von Bakebrunner popped into my head when I was rubbing one. I mean, at first I was kind of thinking about Dagger and that small draw of his, but then Chris just totally sold, though. Probably nothing here. I think I just want her back. Chloe the Electric Sheep. So, hold on. Page 3 of 3. 1 of 3. Dear Max, Dad got me this stationary one that we're probably not going to be reading all of this. When I complained about wanting to send an email and the internet was down. Then I thought, hey, maybe it's time to write Max. The funny thing is, I don't really know what to say, because we haven't talked in 3 months. Despite all my calls, a text, then, not that I'm upset or anything. Fuck, there's no way I'm sending this, is there? Chloe the Unfriended. And this is more like it. Here I can write all to you all I want without wondering or worrying if you'll ever write me back. Maybe one day when you return home and apologize for having forgotten all about me and we kiss and make up, I'll show this to you and we can read it and laugh. Or maybe I'll decide Journal Max is way cooler than Reality Max and you'll just live in here forever as my imaginary former current best friend pal. Time will tell. Chloe the Journal Boss. Good drawings in here, by the way. Ready? So Mom suggests taking a road trip next summer and I'm like, cool, I guess. But then she starts talking about David being here there. Yes, that David, the wannabe drill sergeant who swooped in on Mom and has stuck around like a bad sit. David, the mustache monster from Bad Dipshit. That fucking David! Anyway, I politely suggested to Mom that perhaps it was too early to assume David would be in the picture by then. Or breathing. Hey, shit happens. As you might imagine, that didn't go over well. But really, if this guy's still around 3 months from now, then she's got serious self-esteem issues and I got serious self-immolation. Look it up, nerd plans. You can do better. That's all I meant. But she didn't want to hear it. Like, I'm the asshole. Oh, the asshole. So, here we have... So we have description. My name is Chloe Price, but you can call me. Alright, let's maybe not read all this. Actually, gonna scan it. Okay, 2 years since... her dad died. Which means I think it's gonna be 3 years until Max returns. And we have... Mom and... well, not her dad. Very much not her dad. She sure loves David, doesn't she? Poor Chloe. There's her dad. So then we have, what is this? Shit to tag! Okay, that seems fun. We have a bunch of logs. Oh, and text. Let's see what Mama said. Will you be joining us for supper? No thanks. Will you be coming home at some point tonight? And then I didn't answer. We have Elliot. Oh, let's get to the top here. Spanish deck sucked. Lucky if I passed. Oh, lo siento. No, I think I did okay. Cool. What you up to? Not much. Got shit to do later. Okay. Frank, that's her dealer. Guy with the dog. Your shit's here. Hell yeah! But that's sorry. You're a loss. Hey, can you hold it for me for a day? Can I? I'm your favorite customer. Are you? Frank, you holding? Hello. Gonna have me whacked? Yes, please joke about that over text. You deal drugs on this one. Anyway, come on, it's 420. I'll meet you if you have the cash. Arrgh, hey, check. Right, and we have Max, who... Oof. Hold on, let's check the date. So this is 28th November 2009, and... Wow. It's today anyway, let me just... Okay, yeah, that's 6 months ago. No, 8 months ago. Anyway, let's get to this gig. That's... That's nice, they improved the interface.
No trespassing? No way.
Yep, let's get over that.
Holy shit. This place is awesome. If I'm gonna get inside, I'll have to get through that door.
Nice. Car's over here. Machinery. Look at the machinery.
That saw looks ancient. I wonder how long ago the mill actually closed.
But this, by the way, is not the same voice actor as Chloe was in Life is Strange. Look or,
some there. Say the world will end in fire. Mom would totally flip her shit if she knew I hiked for an hour just to see a show. This place is sketchy as hell. An old abandoned building in the middle of nowhere, miles from home.
I know, I can't really say anything yet. Out of game.
Right. Now I remember why I'm here. Any place is better than home.
It'll be tough to live up to Ashley Burch show. Anyway, yeah, Ashley Burch was on strike while they were doing this, so she had to cancel.
Those
basically.
These guys need to get a room.
Let's not get involved in that.
Or not.
Ow!
Damn.
Mind your own business. I understand.
That guy's an asshole.
This RV's just begging for a little street art. But if I do it here, someone will see me.
What about the backside then? It seems like a good idea, right? Just
perfect place for me to work.
Alright, so we can't rewind in this one, so let's be a little careful.
Now what to draw? Definitely, absolutely not a meth lab.
Alright. Now wait a minute. Oh sweet, that does actually get recorded in here. Oh, you would have gone for the free candy? What if some kid believes that though?
Guess fire safety isn't exactly high on the agenda here.
So we have
This place has collected a lot of junk over the years.
That's for a big dog. Bikes.
I'd join a motorcycle gang if I had any friends.
Ouch. Alright, so this one is separate, I guess.
Nothing says badass like a nice floral print.
It's pretty cool. Your dialogue unlocked. So, hi. I don't suppose you'll just let me in, right?
Help you, miss?
You gotta let me in. Check it. I'm totally legit.
It's not a bad fake, kid. But you're in over your head here. Do yourself a favor and scram.
Huh. Alright, so...
Can't let him push me around. Should I go back and stand up to him? Or can something around here help me convince him? It's an old
lumber
car.
If that's his motorcycle.
Guess it's been years since anyone's actually...
Oh, no, he's just...
Keep walking, kid.
Yeah, fair enough. Alright, so let's try and talk to him, because that was kind of the hint he was giving there. Yeah.
God, again? What do you want, kid?
Nice earrings. oh, hey, yeah, your bike is actually one. Let's try them on.
Is that your bike over there?
Yup.
It's, pretty cool.
Gee, thanks. Is that all?
wow. Very effective. So, that top one looks like an argument, so let's maybe go for the mill.
This is the old mill, right? I heard Firewalk is playing here tonight. They're awesome.
Nope.
Are you kidding?
You should probably just go.
Well, let's try it. Start the backtalk challenge.
I have to convince this doorstop that I'm not giving up until he lets me inside.
Use arguments and insults to get someone to do what you want. This is gonna go very well.
Don't you remember what it's like to be a teenager? I just want to see the band.
I thought we went over this. Isn't it past your bedtime?
Do you pay attention to what your opponent says? Come back that reflects their words back at them. Oh. Huh.
Oh, isn't it past yours?
Oh, look, I got a point for that.
But I still don't know you.
Hey. Cute.
Kittens riding tiny mopeds are cute. I'm more like Red Sonja riding a panzer tank.
Wow.
Okay, kid. I get it. You're tough.
Hey, Grant, that's a good response, kid. I am not a kid doesn't sound like a good idea.
Maybe I am a kid. Because this place looks like a damn playground to me.
A girl like you? I can't protect you in there.
A girl like you, with pretty flowers on her bicycle, shouldn't lecture me on what I can do.
That is a traditional Samoan... Look, my boss decides who gets in, all right?
Is your boss your mom? Follow up. Do you live in your boss's basement?
You're not accepting no for an answer, are you?
Nope.
And you really think you can take me?
Yep.
What if I had a knife?
No problem.
A gun?
Don't care.
What if I had...
You could have a flamethrower, an army of robot ninjas, and a motherfucking dragon on a leash in there, and I'd still kick your ass.
I give up. You're all right, kid. Go on in.
Well... this guy seems pretty nice. I guess he was technically the tutorial of the game. What happens if you fail that, considering you can't rewind it?
This is intense!
Oh,
shit!
Ouch.
Amelia, come!
Cute dog.
Question everything. Why?
Just follow the lights and the sound. Can't wait to get in there and thrash.
I am not betting that dog. Not without asking at least first. Because that is a stupid thing to do.
Sober up, girl. You're missing the show.
That's exactly what we need. Thank you. Yeah,
I mean, I could.
Don't mess with Damon. Thanks for the memo.
Okay, good.
T-shirt. That would help. I guess I would like a T-shirt.
Hey, are you selling any...
20 bucks.
What?
20 bucks for a T-shirt.
That's really expensive. Dick.
No, it gives me an option to take a T-shirt.
That shirt is rad.
Somehow I don't think you'll like it, but...
Hey, I told you 20 bucks. You looking to get beat?
That guy's a dick. If I want a shirt, I'm going to need to get creative.
Alright, so it specifically pointed me towards the stair. Right. Frank?
Half those stairs are rotted through. Looks dicey.
So creative, you say. Hi, Memo. Well, I already beat up a guy with my words. Hey, thanks for the house. Okay, so I'm gonna have to get creative. Let's see. Oh no! His car is like... Oh, his car is like just on an incline. This is gonna go well. You know what? Chloe is like bad decision central in general, so I'm gonna go for it.
Maybe you shouldn't overcharge. Thanks for playing, dick.
All right, now I can take a shirt.
Oh, yeah. Sweet, sweet victory. That's like 200 bucks.
That's probably not a good idea. Well, then again, neither is taking the shirt. Oh, Mamo, that sucks. Hope you feel better soon. That just sucks, is all I can say. You know what? We're making bad decisions tonight. Uh-oh. Oh, I don't like that, Papa.
Holy shit! I'm rich! Nothing sadder than a neglected bomb.
Alright, let's maybe not hang around the car. Yeah, I also thought, let's not do that. Skeevy guys, I should probably not talk to them. Here's a knife.
Sweet knife. Just like the one my mom refused to get me for my birthday.
Chill, girl. That seems like someone we would want to talk to, but I think...
How can you just chill when Firewalk is tearing it up in the next room?
Fair enough. Here's a dartboard.
Reminds me of the way I make important life choices.
Beer. Oh, we could. There's also beer here. Well.
Drink more, feel less. Yes, please.
Yeah, sounds like I didn't deserve you in the first place, dude. I hope you find something quickly. But, well, looking for a job myself, it's not the easy thing in the world. Gotta keep at it. Ooh, evil eye, that's kinda sound bad. I'm basically helping them with their decoration here.
What are you looking at?
Maybe a spiral would have been better, actually. Drunk guy, that...
That's totally me in 5 beers. Okay, 3.
Oh boy. I can already tell this is gonna end
300 dock spectacularly. Workers laid off, their pensions canceled. God, Prescott's a real tool.
Fuck the Prescott's. General. They're the, like, asshole rich family who runs down, so...
Damn, there are a lot of...
I guess I gotta go here.
Here we go.
Excuse me, coming through. Oh, fuck.
Fuck.
That's what I said.
Hey, you okay?
I'm fine.
Relax. You bumped into me, remember?
Yep. My bad, dude.
You don't know who I am, do you?
Nope.
Fuck the fuck off.
Don't care, either.
Hey, let me know how that works out for you, bitch.
All right. Mosh pit is a no-go. Fine.
Yeah, and the Sean Presco that was mentioned there is like his dad, who is essentially even worse than him, and like basically Nathan Prescott, the one who you mentioned, like the apprentice to the evil dude, he's like basically. Oh yeah, right. I should talk to Frank. He's like basically that way because his dad is an abusive shit.
He bought pot for me every month for a year. Look at that getup, studs. You're trying too hard. What are you even doing here?
I'm trying to see this damn band. But this place is crazy packed. Hard to get to the stage.
How'd you even hear about this little shindig?
Ha! The internet. How else?
Seriously? Fucking kids.
Goddamn millennials! You know what? Yeah, let's ask
Did
about
that guy.
Did you
see that guy I ran into? Acted like I was supposed to know who the hell he was.
Yeah, I know him. He works for Damon.
Damon Merrick?
I see you've heard of him. This is his place. Damon's a friend of mine.
Oh. This, by the way, is Frank, who is her dealer, and who is essentially not nearly as bad a guy as he seems to be. Let's ask about the
stairs. Where do those stairs go?
Up.
He's also got a dog out.
Real helpful, Frank. I mean...
He likes beats.
Will I get a better view of the band up there?
How the fuck should I know?
I've been in this chair my whole life.
Okay? No one goes up there.
Fine.
Oh, let's ask.
Okay, so you holding? I could definitely use something to take the edge off.
Of course. As soon as you give me the $175 you owe me.
I did just take that cash from the t-shirt dealer. How about no, actually?
Never mind that.
I guess I did say I was making bad choices today, but... Maybe let's not pick all of them at once. Because he also did mention that upstairs the wood is rotten, so... I'm sure this will be fun. Proud for once, 26.
Yes! Finally made it!
Don't jump so hard on the wood, please. Such a dork, oh my god. Bit safer, these notes are lying down, spreading out the weight over the planks. But yeah, that floor is really wrecked. Do you like that you can just like sit for a while in these games, by the way? Uh-oh! Ooh, get up! Shit!
I'll show you how unimpressed I am with limp dick ass assholes who get butthurt over a spilled beer.
I think she's calling us out, dude.
She's gonna regret every word. Every word.
Oh, this is gonna be good.
I'm gonna teach this little punk some manners.
I'm serious. You wanna see me get angry here? Because I'm getting there. And it won't be pretty. It won't.
She thinks she can take you?
What do we do? What do we do? Fuck! Going for it. Thank you.
Rachel?
Oh shit!
Come on! Hurry up!
I'm caught up in the traps of you still having guns. A voice is filled with pain. Lost. No one gave it toss.
Frank's not so bad.
Calm down. Come on, man. Walk away. Screw this.
What an amazing accent. How cool we're sticking around. Oh, this went better than expected. I assume that Rachel was Rachel Amber, who is the girl who is missing in the original game, was Chloe's girlfriend. Yeah, that makes sense. I mean, yeah, I hadn't even thought that she would presumably appear in this game. Yeah, I mean, I assume she's gonna be a major character then. I'm going into this blind, by the way.
Sometimes, all I want to do is shut my eyes and tell the world to go to hell.
She's good here at the table. Right, because she's pretty good at science and stuff.
Hey, Dad. Another day in paradise. Right? Daily rituals are important. Even when they involve writing unread letters to friends who have forgotten you.
Writing to Max the Loser. Yeah, that's right. I called you a loser. Wanna know why? Because you were in that firewall last night. Even Frank was there. He's my dealer. Or Mom, if you're reading this, he's my dealer and you shouldn't be reading this. It was maybe the greatest night of my life. I hiked to this old mill using the train tracks and verbally abused his dumb bouncer until he let me sit. The bouncer was kind of chill. Firewall was the shit. When new rages like that went down in old Arcadia Bay. Fuck Seattle. Plus, I have a sweet-ass black eye for a souvenir. No big deal, but there were these two asshole creepy guys whose manhood I racked. Oh yeah, and I got rescued by the most popular girl at school. How was your night, loser? The Firebolt plus Chloe is greater than Max.
Chloe, wakey-wakey, eggs and bacon.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Last night,
that would be
seeing Firewalk
kind of going towards a set ending. Although,
assholes.
To be fair, the original Life is Strange didn't have that excuse. It kind of had that issue as well in the fifth episode, I felt.
Was that really Rachel Amber? You smell like cigarettes and beer. Better change clothes.
First, we gotta look about the room.
That really was Rachel Amber. And she saved my life. How was last night even real? Ask Miss Arcadia. You're the only source of info I trust in this town.
Oh, this is how she learned about the party, I guess.
Wait, what? Who? What
the
photo?
90s?
I have feelings about this.
Oh, hey.
Most of them are not good feelings.
Terrible news, my fellow Oregonians. Our very own Pacific Steve's famous crab
yeah,
is shutting its doors.
I think Life is Strange was in like 2012, something, 2010 maybe, so this should be... Oh wait, actually we already said... Wait, no, we don't have a phone right now. I think I thought that it was in 2009, this game. Hey, Mr. Sharky.
Fun fact. Shark babies eat their siblings in the womb. Maybe that's why I'm an only child. Used to dream of riding a unicorn as a kid. But then all the unicorns died.
Let's keep it up for now. Drawer.
Max
Fire Power!
Years ago.
That's the cutest thing ever.
And because it was Max, not a single song was pirated.
It doesn't then, huh. Yep. Oh yeah, that would make sense.
As
yeah.
awesome as some of those shows with Elliot were, they were nothing compared to Firewalk last night. Mom said I was too young to go. She was wrong. And it was awesome. I used to love skateboarding. It's the only mode of transportation.
This place is a little different in Life is Strange. Well, actually that much. I think pirate hats, can I put it
I
on?
I bet Long Max Silver traded her hat for beer and booty long ago. Nice one, Chloe. Mom's gonna love the new look.
Yeah, I think I had flat screen by then. I mean, could be because they're kind of bored at... Oh shit, I get to pick? The firewalk shirt, have you got? This one really speaks to me. Bonus outfits.
87.9 FM The Satyr is supported by listeners like you.
The Illuminati shirt, I guess.
Feel free to donate money if you want to. Anytime. Literally any amount. We'll take it.
But that's pretty much her look in Life is Strange. Well, minus the blue hair and the beanie stuff. Change option here. I'm just gonna actually check them all out right now. So. Hot dog, man. That is a good look. Let's see, then we have the firewalk shirt. Which of course is basically booty from last night, so hey. Love that you get the choice. You have this raven. Or the Skeletor Butterfly. Yeah, it's definitely either this one or the What a dough that I'm gonna go for. Let's stick with this one for now.
I really should get going.
Alright. I think we've looked at everything in here.
Shit. Where's my phone? God, it's not here. How drunk was I last night?
Chloe, I said breakfast.
Guess I better try calling my phone with Mom's.
Mom's?
Okay. Mom's phone is probably in her room. I can use it to call mine, then figure out where the hell I left it.
Home sweet home.
Whoever said you can't go home again was probably from Arcadia Bay. And he could go home again. He just didn't want to.
Alright, well, there's the phone. Here's a bed.
Mom's finally making her bed again? I guess that's a good sign.
Storytelling there. There's the phone. Oh, I can pick two different phones, I guess.
Mom's
oh, no, wait.
Engagement ring.
It's a ring. I thought it
supposed
meant
to
ring
be
the
mine,
phone.
If I'm ever stupid enough to get married. Grade B? Fuck you, Arcadia Pawn. Wait. Mom's selling her engagement ring? Can't believe I used to sneak in there for her makeup. I made this for Mom when I was like 10 years old. If she wore it now, I'm not sure which of us would be more embarrassed. I hate that she hides all our old pictures of Dad.
Oh, I'm not gonna place it under the dresser if she hides it. I imagine she does that for a reason. I don't seem to be able to close the drawer though.
David comes here for dinner.
I guess I had that comic looking. Alright, let's go.
How can Mom look at this every day and not see what a tool she's dating? Sounds like my phone is definitely nearby.
I assume it's not in Mom's drawer. Well, maybe, I guess it would be David's drawer?
It's weird that Mom's always hoarding these old catalogs. It's not like we have any money.
Hold on. What is this book?
Sometimes you have to get knocked down lower than you've ever been to stand up taller than you ever were. Blech.
Love after loss.
Don't give up on yourself. A single spark can start a fire that burns the entire prairie. Better.
A little hung up on the bed there, so hold on. Is it outside? No, it sounds like it's in here somewhere. No, wait, it's definitely lower now.
All right, phone.
Hold on.
Donde estás?
Is it just in my room? Don't know if she got in. Hold on.
Mom's hiding her gray hair to impress her boyfriend. Maybe gray hair is his kryptonite. Maybe I should dye my hair gray.
Or maybe. Oh, there it is.
There we go. Wonder how many calls I've missed.
Well, one at least. Ooh. I like that she didn't respond at all to those. And there's Elliot.
Chloe, breakfast. Bring my purse down with you, please.
Yeah, yeah. Okay.
I think I saw Mom's purse in her room.
I did indeed. Let's go get it. There it is.
Oh, can you grab my cell phone too?
Got it.
No more dawdling. I need to talk to you.
Yeah, that really makes me want to hurry.
Why did she put that purse? I mean, in her inventory, but...
Coming, Mom.
Finally, you can put my purse on the dining table. You might still have time for breakfast if you hurry.
Dining table, here I come. Dad took these photos. Now that David's staying over so much, I wonder how long it'll take Mom to shove them in a drawer somewhere. Pot roast?
Talk to Mom, but...
Mom hates pot roast.
Go put my purse on the table before you forget.
Alright,
it's not that I'm ungrateful. It's just that when your mom works in a diner, you're not always in the mood for diner-type food.
Fair enough.
How can bacon smell so good, but I'd still rather stuff these sugar bombs in my mouth? Dad's old swear jar. We spent the last of his curses on bus fare and milk.
Hold on, let's... Before we do, I got the newspaper.
Wow. Sean Prescott's son Nathan goes to my school. Sounds like the apple didn't fall far from the asshole. Why do I suddenly want to get some fireworks?
This is Principal Ray Wells. Let me be emphatic. I have an enormous stick inserted into my butt. Thank you. Also, Chloe, you're poor and in trouble.
Button. What does it do?
We're already supporting
that kind of
one.
Button.
Thanks. From when Max and I spilled Mom's wine. I think the only reason Mom hasn't recarpeted is so she can stay mad at me. It's my job to water these plants, but it was Dad's job to remind me, so. Nobody's fault, really. Family pic used to hang here. Wow.
Yeah, so
I can't
Mom definitely can't bear to look at photos of Dad right now.
Aren't you glad you left for Seattle, Max?
And never looked back? Dad always talked about upgrading to a flat screen. Too bad that never happened. I would have gotten this bad boy in my room. Any letter from Blackwell is never good.
Oh, wait a minute.
Is Mom having trouble with payments again? My scholarship doesn't cover everything. Like I need another reason for Principal Wells to get on my case. Mom doesn't want me to know, but it's pretty clear her boy toy, David, hasn't worked in like a year.
Alright, let's put the purse on the table.
Chloe, I don't have all day. Would you get over here already?
I should see what Mom wants before she strokes out.
All right, Mom.
Hey, Mom. You wanted to talk?
Chloe, what happened to you?
It's no big deal. I walked into a door.
You seem to be walking into a lot of doors lately. When I send you a text message, Chloe, like last night, I need you to answer.
You can just say text. You don't have to say message.
And I need you to answer without the snark.
Sorry. I hear you. I'll do better about replying.
Thank you.
Is that what you wanted to talk about?
What is it with you and David? Always cutting to the chase. Why can't we just have some pleasant conversation before school?
I thought you hated pot roast.
You can have a no thank you helping.
No, you hate pot roast. I don't care.
I don't hate it. And David likes it. And don't say you don't care.
So that's what we're doing now? Whatever your boyfriend likes?
You do realize I hate your boyfriend with every fiber of my being, right?
Chloe! You don't hate him.
He calls me girly. He's a dickhole.
He can be old-fashioned.
Yeah, an old-fashioned dickhole.
Yeah, he really... I mean, he's got issues and that stuff, but yeah.
Ah, right. School. My favorite.
You used to love to learn.
Yeah. I used to think drugs were lame, too.
I wish you wouldn't joke like that.
Are you selling your engagement ring?
Chloe, jewelry gets appraised for all sorts of reasons. Like for insurance.
Nice dodge.
How about this? You don't go in my bedroom when I'm not there.
Ask How about you don't ask me to get your damn purse then?
Let's not fight. I made you breakfast.
Nah. I'll just grab something later.
Oh, you'll enjoy this. The other day I made 4 eggs, 2 for David, 2 for me. And just before I served them, he says, "What are you gonna eat?"
Yeah, tough crowd.
I'll enjoy that, huh?
Tired, huh? That'll teach you to break curfew.
What?
I know what time you came home last night. And don't think you can get out of school just because you missed the bus again.
Why would you assume that-
Who do you think your principal calls when you skip? Do you think I enjoy lying for you, saying you're sick just so you don't get expelled? Between your grades and your disregard for my rules, I see you slipping. I'm worried.
But Mom, the whole point of lowering expectations is so you won't be disappointed in me. Never again.
You're happy doing what you're doing? Fine. Keep at it. Just let me know so I can stop fighting with Blackwell to keep you on scholarship. Money's tight enough as it is.
Hmm. Your dad's gonna put the money? Yeah.
Maybe David should start paying rent. He spends the night often enough.
How would you know? You're never here yourself. David thinks you need discipline.
David should mind his own business.
I think it's great David's taking an interest. He's a good man. Maybe he can help.
Your boyfriend's an asshole.
He's been good for me. Maybe he rubs you the wrong way because you've been rude.
He's still breathing. That means I've been more than fair.
David's had some hard times too, you know. If he's kind enough to share his experience, I expect you to listen.
Like I'd let him get within 15 feet of me.
When he takes you to school today.
Very funny.
You will be nice, you will be respectful, and you will say thank you.
It's gonna only go
well.
Are
you serious? This is such...
What, Chloe? Such what?
Mom's trying, I guess. Maybe I should too. But what's the point in getting along if it means pretending everything's fine when it's not? Mom. I know you're dealing with a lot.
Thank you. I understand you don't need me as much anymore. But I need you.
I do still need you. You're my mom.
I'm proud of you for being so self-sufficient. But the whole world's not out to get you.
Tell that to the world.
You're impossible. But I love you.
I love you too.
Mm-hmm. Okay, David's waiting. You'll need to bring him his keys from the ashtray. Try not to kill each other.
Got it. Unless he tries to give me advice. Or looks at me funny.
Chloe.
Or looks at me at all.
Chloe.
Mom.
Have a good day.
You too. Bringing David his keys is about the most humiliating thing Mom could ask me to do.
Oh, we can give the money to Mom. Hmm. We obviously we are having issues. Good.
You're welcome.
So, let's see. The ashtray. Where do you keep an ashtray? Never lived in a house where people... Oh, there we go. Smoke inside, so...
Here they are.
I do not know where you keep these things inside. Yeah, that's me. Robin Hood.
Let's get these to David so he can drive away.
Guess we're the vet.
No point in putting off the inevitable torture of driving to school with David.
David.
Better get going.
There's no way this ride goes well, is there? Oh, hey, someone else. Is this Chloe? This is Steph Gingrich. Here's DVD, you can get it before school. Thanks. Forward to, I guess. Window. Yes, it's a window.
I actually have to let this jack-off drive me to school. This is my life now. Kill
right,
me.
Let's try and be friends with David. Hide everything. I suspect I know how that's gonna turn out, considering she still hates him in Life is Strange.
What a piece of crap.
That's pretty bad,
car,
too. Nice!
Why do you women always take forever to get ready?
Oh.
We're hoping you men will leave without us.
That's a good start.
No, Mom. I swear he beat himself to death with a tire iron. Repeatedly.
Chloe, is that a black eye?
No.
Insubordination. No wonder
Seriously,
your mother's worried about you.
Dude?
Oh, that's sweet.
When I was your age, I got into my share of scraps. But it's not responsible. You owe it to your mother to do better.
Tell me again what I owe my mother, dirtbag.
At least you didn't say that out loud.
Electro insulator's probably cracked. You know what a spark plug does?
Yes.
It ignites.
Did you not hear me? I said I know what it does.
Then go grab my socket wrench set from the garage, and we can get moving.
What is this? Quality time? Ugh. Better just get the socket wrench and get this over with.
Muscle car.
Tiniest penis in all of Arcadia Bay. What's David doing, leaving stuff in our garage anyway? Does he think he's moving in or something?
Yes, does he have the surveillance system set up yet? Toolbox.
By toolbox, did David mean this, or did he mean himself?
There it is.
There's his stupid socket wrench set. Let's get the 50-50 chance I smash him in the face with this. 60-40. Maybe 90-10.
Man, imagine what Chloe would do if she had to agree. We went, oh, I could gravity it. I mean, I am trying to get along with him. It's gonna be very tough, but I'm actually gonna not gravity his toolbox.
Do these have chapters on hotwiring your mom's boyfriend's car so you can drive it off a cliff? Asking for a friend. Uh-oh. Mom's been cleaning again. This was the photo Mom took down from the living room. Guess we don't have room for it and David's mustache.
Lawnmower.
David's lawnmower. Maybe Mom and I like our lawn the way it is. Everything Dad's toolbox. He used to get so excited whenever anything sprung a leak or busted. Dad's old camera.
Ooh, she gives that to Max, doesn't she?
Do they even make film for these anymore? Damn. The stereo used to be in Dad's workshop. I should hook it up in my room before garbage day gets it first. Should fill this with gasoline just in case David's car ever catches on fire.
All right. Let's make friends with David. Look at Ranch him.
A little more hustle wouldn't have killed you.
Not finished looking at everything yet.
See what's gunking up the works there? That's a sign of
carbon deposits. No shit.
You know, you could actually be good at this if you lost the attitude.
My attitude is what makes me special, David.
All right.
God. Okay, let's do it.
Fine. Whatever. Hey, you're taking those tools with you, right?
Every house needs a good toolbox.
We've already got one, but thanks.
It's smaller than mine.
Ready to roll?
Please don't want to talk. Please don't want to talk.
I
want
to talk to you about something.
Fuck.
We don't have to like each other, but you will respect me. You've enjoyed enough of a vacation from having a father figure. So there's some things I want to be real clear about.
Oh boy. It's very tempting.
Respect him? I think it's time I show this asshole I'm not interested in anything he has to say. What's clear is fuck you.
Language. You are way out of line, young lady.
Language? Here, let me put that in a language you'll understand. Foxtrot. Uniform.
You've got a smart mouth, don't you?
Let me dumb it down for you. I mean, sorry. What has fewer syllables than dumb?
Hey, watch your... I can crap bigger than you, got it?
Oh, that's what I smell. A giant load of crap.
You... Your mother... You're breaking her heart.
Leave Mom out of this. This is about you, and me, and you being an asshole.
I was in the army. You will respect me.
I don't remember enlisting, so don't treat me like your newest recruit.
Maybe I should have gone for ignoring the
German.
If
you were a man,
I'd... It's cool. If you were a man, I wouldn't go so easy on you, either.
Don't know why I bother trying.
Mission accomplished.
Same, really.
Country music?
Oh, yeah.
I'd love this song. I just called to tell you that I miss you, my old friend. Burning midnight oil again. What a beautiful day.
I know what a spark plug does, jerkwad. I guess Mom left her purse back here?
There's Dad.
Dad, turn it up.
Yeah, same. This is gonna go suddenly very horrible, isn't it? Picking up my lover from the grocery store. Oh, poor Chloe. Oh no.
Out of the car, Chloe. You're gonna be late.
Let's try and mend some bridges.
Shit. Thanks.
Don't use that sarcastic tone with me, young lady. I can see you rolling your eyes.
Hello? I was actually saying
See everything.
I'll warn everything.
I wonder how that would have gone if I had endured, ignored and endured.
Brock's day will mess you up!
Like seniors. I don't know what year this is. I can never remember what the different years are in America. How weird to have like different names for them instead of just first year, second year, third year, fourth year, fifth year, sixth year. What was there? I didn't notice a weird reflection. I mean, reflections tend to be kind of difficult to render, I believe so.
Hey, Chloe.
Oh, hey, Elliot.
What's the dude who texts me?
Wait, what happened to your face? Do you need to go to the nurse or something?
What? This? You should see the other guy.
Guess it's true then. I heard you had a hell of a night. I mean, people are talking about it.
People can eat a dick. Even social media haters can't ruin how awesome last night was.
So, how about The Tempest? Blackwell Theater at its most pretentious.
Yeah, totally.
I know it's gonna be lame, but I was thinking, do you wanna go together tomorrow?
I like the options here. No, no, and yes, but that sounds awful. Or maybe. I assume that. Well, you know what? Let's give it a shot.
I try to make it a rule not to go to school any more than I have to, but sitting in the back row and making fun of the drama kids might not suck.
Right? That's totally what I was thinking.
All right. See you in chem.
Yeah, for sure.
Why is he reading his textbook on the school campus?
Gotta track down Steph to pick up my DVD. I've still got time before class.
Ha! That's a pretty cool way to do your energetic. Objective.
Maybe this play won't suck. Maybe.
It looks good. Plays are usually pretty fun.
How could I possibly make it through a day in this place without a little chemical assistance? Meh. Well, at least not for now.
Heat. Warning, Brooke. Hey. Picnic tables in Mikey. Thanks on my way.
The future needs excellence. The future's an asshole.
Got picnic tables. Oh boy. Hello.
Oh, Carrie Price!
It's Chloe.
Oh, right. I'm just teasing.
Why did I decide to talk to you?
You have been taking me so seriously since I won the Beacon's Young Artist Award for my photography.
You don't say.
Between that and the Vortex Club, it's hard to keep people from putting me up on a pedestal or whatever.
Uh-huh.
But you know all about that. What with Rachel Amber? Am I right?
Wait. What about Rachel Amber?
Rachel posted a slamming selfie of you two having the time of your lives. Do tell.
It was a pretty normal night for us. A little music, a little dancing. We murdered a guy.
You are so funny. Oh, seriously, though. I didn't realize you and Rachel were such BFFs.
We're really not.
So, what's she into? You know, what's her thing? Is it drugs? I'm not judging or anything.
Is it drugs?
I figure if she's hanging out with you, she must be into some effed up shit. You know?
Seriously, I don't know why you're talking to me about Rachel.
Oh, everybody loves her. Little Miss Perfect.
So you're jealous of Rachel Amber. That's what's happening right now. Gotcha.
Oh, God, I don't have time for this. I didn't even finish the chemistry assignment, and you're being you. Oh.
Sabotage your homework? Hell yes, let's do it.
I'm sorry, Victoria. I didn't mean to be rude. You know, I finished the assignment. Want some help?
You? Help me?
Of course. That last problem was hard, right? If I'm remembering correctly, the answer was fluorine, uranium, carbon, potassium, and, uranium again. Does that sound right?
Perfect. Hey! Thanks, Carrie.
No problem.
Hey, that was a bit mean. Worth it. Samantha, let's talk to Samantha. You are not the person I'm looking for, but...
Hey, Chloe.
Hey, Samantha. What are you reading?
Who's Afraid of Virginia Woolf?
I read that last year in Mrs. Hoyta's English class.
I didn't think you did homework.
Normally I don't.
Yeah, Victoria is awful.
The play was actually good.
What did you like about it?
I actually managed to befriend her this time when I was playing Life is Strange. It takes a lot of kissing up to her. And she's still pretty shitty.
It's funny. The title's actually a play on the song, Who's Afraid of the Big Bad Wolf?
And that's funny?
Wrong answer.
It is if you're the wolf.
I'm not sure if you're joking. Sorry, I'm a little slow sometimes.
I'm a little bitchy sometimes, so it's cool.
People always say that. But I think you're actually... Sorry, Chloe. No one says anything like that. I don't know what I'm actually talking about.
I bet.
Right, she's pretty sweet. There's the picnic tables. They're playing D&D.
If I had known the Celestial Avenger was bloodied, I would have totally given him my potion.
Yep.
It was a skill challenge. Potion wouldn't have worked.
Skill challenge?
It's part of the tabletop game we play.
You wouldn't understand.
I used to play with my friend Max. It's been a long time, though.
Cool. Now that is a creature I wouldn't want to fight.
Got my DVD?
One Blade Runner. Director's cut coming right up.
Sweet. $5, right?
Keep it. I'm just glad someone here appreciates the classics. You even asked for the director's cut, which took out the shitty voiceover and replaced it with a sweet dream sequence.
Dream life over real life. That's my motto.
Right on.
Never actually watched Blade Runner.
Hey, do you know if Rachel's a gamer?
Rachel Amber? You're asking me?
Didn't you two go out last night, or was it just like a friend thing?
I don't know what you heard, but Rachel and I barely know each other.
Oh, sweet.
Steph has a crush.
Chloe, you should join our game.
Yeah, I don't have 50 hours right now. Thanks, though.
We're at the end of the campaign, so it'll only take, like, 20 minutes. What else have you got to do before class?
Clint?
What the hell? Game on, nerds.
Here's a character sheet. You are an elf barbarian.
Nice. I could totally see myself as an elf barbarian.
I know, I'm good. All right, let's get started. You are both famous heroes in the Kingdom of Avernon, a once peaceful land, now laid to waste by the bloodthirsty raiders of the Black Well. Alone, you have fought your way through the raider camps, seeking their warlord leader, Durgaron, the Unscarred. As you enter the final camp, bloodied and weary, you see your fellow hero approaching from the opposite direction.
I raise my staff to you in greeting. I am Elamah, Wizard of the Third Circle, foremost advisor to King Tiberius, and sworn defender of Avernum.
Introduce your character.
Yeah, okay. I'm an elf barbarian named,
Warp. I'm gonna go for Calamastia.
Calamastia.
Super into it.
Not bad.
The two heroes.
Hold on.
Warp is pretty good, yeah, but too obvious.
Elamah narrows his eyes at the elf in front of him and says, I am here to defeat Durgaron, the Unscarred. In the name of King Tiberius, what makes you think you are worthy to fight alongside me?
Well, I'm not gonna go according to my character sheet here.
I once stabbed a guy in the chest with a sword, and it went all the way through and killed the guy behind him too. True story.
Gotta get into this. I love that you can just join this D&D game, by the way. That's amazing.
Freeway crossing. To your left, the raiders' training ground. To your right, their prison camp. Straight ahead, an enormous, ostentatious tent that could only belong to Durgaron, the Unscarred. Which way do you go?
Straight ahead, right? We're supposed to kill the Durr dude.
Elamah frowns. The raiders could have some good loot at the training ground, and surely it is our duty to free all those prisoners.
Your choice, newbie. Where do you wish to go?
Well, yes and, of course. Let's follow him. Sure, let's go to the training ground.
Loot sounds good. Let's go to the training ground.
Sweet.
Upon arriving at the training ground, you are spotted by a heavy-set orc who immediately shouts and points. There are a dozen raiders on the training field, all of whom raise their weapons and charge.
Okay. So what do we do?
I cast Urgul's Acid Blast.
Urgul's Acid Blast.
Overkill?
Bam!
You conjure up a wave of acid that washes over the charging orcs. Every raider suddenly starts screaming and writhing in pain. There's a sweet and sour kind of smell as the flesh melts off their bones like warm candle wax.
He's real descriptive.
Holy shit.
You see why I haven't really needed a partner?
The heavy-set orc sergeant still remains. He runs at you, swinging a massive warhammer.
All yours.
Fatal cleave,
okay, something. Let's end this. Fatal cleave.
You swing your great axe.
Reminder
down
of get your chemistry glass on the hand.
The orc blinks, then splits open like a hot dog bun.
Fuck yeah! I'm awesome at this game.
It's going well.
What about the loot?
Well, as the training ground is now a roiling pit of acid, it's unlikely any loot survives.
Hey!
Dang.
Well, again, let's be nice to our new friends.
Don't worry, Elamon guy. We all make mistakes.
Elamon nods. Calamastia, the elf barbarian, is most wise and forgiving.
What's next?
Well, we also want to do the prison camp, I guess.
Guess it's time to free some peeps. Let's go to the prison camp.
You behold a field of standing iron cages, each imprisoning a human villager.
Don't do the acid wave thing again, please.
Only a small, elderly dragonkin is keeping watch. He notices you, and in terror, runs into one of the few empty cages and locks himself in.
Ah, poor little guy. What's a dragonkin?
Dragonkin are like little dragon people. They're assholes. I bet he has all the keys.
Oh, okay. Hey, shitface! Get out of there!
The Dragonkin hops up and down, shaking his ring of keys at you. He shouts in a strange language. Whatever he's saying probably isn't flattering.
Got any useful spells in that robe of yours?
Nothing that wouldn't blow up the cage and everything in it.
You know what? I want to try tempting him with bread and then...
Apparently, I have bread. I try to tempt the little bastard out with it.
He sticks out his tongue, finding your offering disgusting.
Hey, bread is great, jerk. All right, let's go for
Intimidate.
It.
Intimidate. That's a skill I have.
I'm a barbarian.
Can
I can't
do that?
Get locked.
I want the little bastard to shit his pants.
You can try. What do you say?
Listen up, you little lizard.
Unfortunately, he doesn't speak common, which means he can't...
I cast communication on the dragon.
Thanks, buddy.
Shit. Really?
Now he can understand every word you say.
Time to work some real magic.
So this is called a skill challenge, where you try to use...
Oh, I know what this is. I grab the bars of the cage and lean in, nice and close.
He steps back, his scaly skin quivering in fear. What do you say?
Shoes?
You know
right,
I love? Making shoes out of dragonkin. I point at my shoes. I'm wearing a pair, now, Air Dragonkins. There's something special about your scaly skin, how it's waterproof but also breathes. So comfy.
He doesn't seem to like that idea.
Neither do I.
The Dragonkin pleads with you. Please don't harm me, tall one. But I cannot give you key. Durgaron, much taller and meaner than you.
You're short, I say. But you can always get shorter. Give me the key, or I'll chop off your legs and beat you to death with them.
But Dragonkin cowers before you, looking left and right. He opens his jaws, and you think he's about to yell for help.
I interrupt his yell by shoving my axe into the cage, pinning his head to the bars without hurting him.
He's really into
then
this.
Then I say the following.
This is going to be good.
Here's what's up. I'm going to carve the skin from your bones. Then I'm going to turn your skin into a little leather handbag that I'll shove your skinless body into so I can carry it around with me wherever I go. That way, the next time some asshat refuses to give me a key I want, I can pull your body out and show them what happens. How does that sound?
Wow.
That was
nuts.
I'm going to give you a plus 10 bonus to charisma. Go ahead and roll. A small pool of urine collects under the elderly dragonkin as, hands trembling, it hands you the keys. Then it dies of fear.
Awesome.
Yeah!
Go team! Why don't you start unlocking the prisoners?
I'm on it.
As you free them, the prisoners run away from you in fear. What's next?
I love how much of this there is, by the way.
It's tent time.
You enter the tent to find Durgaron, warlord of the raiders of the Black Well, sitting comfortably at his throne. He's a huge red-eyed minotaur, swathed in a fine black cloak, gripping a two-handed sword that's easily 6 feet long. His laughter bellows, wah-ha-ha-ha-ha. Your lands and people are already mine. Your deeds here mean nothing. Your kingdom was weak. You are weak.
What
yeah, I'm having fun with this. This is amazing.
I cast Zael's Cataclysm.
Been able to join a D&D game in a video game before.
Fire fizzles out on contact. Durgaron laughs again, holding up his right arm to show off his bracer of fire immunity.
Shit. All of my battle spells are fire-based.
Except for, you know, Acid Blast. Which someone used unnecessarily to show off for Chloe. Calamastia? What'll it be?
Punch his motherfucker.
I want to punch that stupid man cow in the dick.
I wonder if she would be less into this if in the first
right
one.
Right in the dick?
Couple of options.
Right in
you,
the dick.
You selected the less interested ones.
You
like
miss.
The, according to my
Durgaron
character sheet.
Durgaron burst out
blah, blah, blah.
Laughing as you stumble past him.
Asshole.
He gores you in the side with a horn. 8 damage.
You didn't even roll for that.
What do you do next?
Well, annihilation strike sounds good.
Oh, holy shit! Annihilation strike. That sounds boss as fuck.
One?
Fuck.
That's bad, right?
Not for me. As you take your first step, you trip on a rock, collapsing onto the ground in a clangy jumble of metal. Your axe swings wildly to the side. Mikey, roll a reflex save.
Oh no, three.
Your axe strikes Elamon's leg. Legs, plural. Severing both feet at the ankles.
Wow, she is a brutal DM.
This game is awesome.
My feet?
Durgaron moves toward your feet, the dude. Crippled Elamon.
Oh, shit.
I told you this was my best boss.
You didn't tell me my character might die.
Durgaron approaches, stomping his bloody hooves. Stomp, stomp, stomp.
This is all my fault. Sort of. What should I do?
Here. It's protected then.
Jump in front of Elamon.
I mean, this is his campaign.
Thanks, Chloe. I mean, thanks, Calamastia.
Okay. Durgaron has now turned his attention toward you.
Bring it.
He charges, thrusting madly with his great sword.
Shit!
Oh, no.
Your attempt to dodge his thrust fails. Durgaron laughs as he impales you on his blade, lifting you high into the air.
Seriously?
I can't do anything with that stupid bracer. I'm sorry, Chloe.
Hey, I chopped your feet off.
Like I said, she's a brutal DM.
You feel your strength draining away as Durgaron lifts you higher into the air. It hurts like hell. What do you do?
I take one last swing at Durface's head.
You'll have to roll high to hit. You're almost dead.
Oh no.
11. You swing, catching Durgaron on the side of his head, severing one horn, but you don't do enough damage to kill him.
What an asshole!
He laughs, then rips you off his sword
for glass,
with
by
a
the way.
Vicious jerk. You die painfully.
So mean.
I'm sorry, Chloe. I have to escape.
Hey, man. If you can, do it.
I cast Warden's Hideaway.
You sure?
It's all I've got.
You summon a spectral door, which shields you from Durgaron. Light flares out, blinding him. The door swings shut, then disappears. You are gone from sight and cannot be harmed.
I guess I'll have to come back when I'm stronger.
That was fun.
Check out what I drew.
Mikey's got serious drawing skills.
Wow, you did it during the game.
Sorry I died and left you out
there
to
fend for yourself.
These
people, I believe, weren't actually in Life is Strange.
It's cool. I'll get them. Eventually.
Glad you enjoyed it, Chloe.
Yeah. I'll adventure with you anytime.
We'll see. Thanks for the game, nerds.
That was fun. Alright, so... Wow, that took like 20 minutes, didn't it?
DVD, check. Next stop, chemistry class. Joy.
Yeah, we should maybe hurry. I don't know how much it took. I think there was a clock at the... a couple minutes to 8. We still have a lot of time, actually. I wonder if it stays on that mode. Let's maybe check what's over there, then. I guess it's for the play that they were mentioning.
Do not walk on stage.
Jesus. I am not gonna listen to that. Sit on the crate.
I should probably be getting to class, but I just don't care. Did last night really happen? The internet says it did, but I still can't believe it. Rachel Amber. The drama star, honor student, popular princess of Blackwell, swoops in like a Batman to save my ass and thrash to Firewalk? Either that was a dream or real life just got a shit ton crazier.
really like that. I really like those spots where you can. You can just sit down. I wasn't walking. Well, now I am.
Principal Wells. Hey.
Chloe Price. Is that a black eye?
Yep.
I hope you know that Blackwell provides confidential counseling services for all our students. We are a safe space for any issue.
I'm good. It's the other guy who needed a safe space. From me.
You never fail to conform to your reputation, do you? Miss Price, the sign clearly says do not walk on the stage. Such disregard for your fellow students' efforts won't alleviate your record of major infractions.
I swear to you, I did not walk on that stage. It was more of a saunter.
Do I look amused to you?
I don't know. I've only seen you with one expression. That's the one.
Perhaps you will find me less amusing if I mention the various allegations I've been hearing about your drug use. You know Blackwell has a zero tolerance policy. Do I have to initiate a search of your person in order to establish the veracity of these allegations, Miss Price? That's what I thought. I'll look forward to seeing you in my office after school today. How does that sound?
Oh dear. I wonder if we could actually get out of this if we went into discussion about it. Let's try it.
Wells really has it out for me. I have to convince him it's in his best interest to back off. Actually, sir, I'm gonna go with no.
Ah. So you're going to mouth off to me now, yes? And here I thought your well of witticisms had finally run dry.
Sir, my well of witticisms runs so deep that you would get trapped at the bottom and never make it out alive.
Jokes, in my experience, that's how the guilty cover up their infractions.
Sorry, Wellesley, but you've fallen right into my trap. I've been recording this entire conversation for my blog about human rights abuses at Blackwell.
You have a blog. Hold on. What abuses have you endured?
You know, I've had to talk to you for like 2 minutes. That's a long time.
We are a private institution, and policy allows me to search all students on the premises.
Hey, honesty is the best policy, right? So I guess I should tell the truth about all the drug use going on at the school. To you, to the Beacon, to anyone who asks.
Ow.
I'm sure we do not need to make so public an issue of your behavior today. But make no mistake, Miss Price. This is not over.
Ooh, goody. I love cliffhangers.
I feel like that should have worked.
Just a couple years ago, something like that would have scared the crap out of me. These days, I'm at, like, the collegiate level of not giving any fucks.
Alright, I think we have space. Well, maybe over here.
If I'm late to class, that's just one more excuse
okay,
for
fine.
Mom to sit
Let's just
David
go.
On me.
Good point. Let's try.
What the hell?
What have you got here?
Prescott.
Twitch.
Don't call me that!
True North. A jock so dumb he makes jocks look bad. Guess Nathan Prescott made the shit list.
Oh, wow. This is some really weird crap, Prescott.
It's not yours. Give it back.
I hate that you're on the team now. You're such a loser.
Guys, no need to fight. You can both be losers.
The mute speaks? Whoa! You earn a spot on the squad, Twitch. You don't have your dad try to buy off the coach. At least my family pays tuition. How much financial aid does your deadbeat dad need again?
Oh, fuck you, dude.
Wow. Dick move, Nathan.
My dad lost his job at the shipyard when your dad closed it down. And you want to talk shit to me?
Leave Nathan alone.
You know something, Prescott? I'm gonna do you a favor. You can't be a part of the team and be into this stupid crap at the same time. You're a piece of shit. I am going to kill you.
You guys, stop! Chloe, do something! Don't just stand there watching!
I mean, you're both assholes. Kind of tempted to just let this play out, but, let's... You know, let's do it.
The only way to stop a bully is to be aggressive. I've got to put Drew down.
Back off, idiot.
What the hell did you just say to me?
I'm gonna call it now. Nathan is gonna be a massive asshole when he,
Back off? As in,
when we get him out of this.
No one's interested in your crap.
You're seriously defending Nathan Prescott?
How about picking on someone your own size? Which I hear is pretty small.
You're such a crazy freak. Mind your own business.
What's crazy is that you haven't been held back yet. How is that possible?
You want a piece of this?
Please. Kicking your ass is going to be a piece of cake.
Did you just laugh?
I did. Chloe just owned you.
Shut the fuck up, fresh meat.
It feels like it should have quotations around it.
Go Samantha.
Guess you got lucky this time, Prescott. Had two girls show up to save you. Take your pervy picture book.
Are you okay?
You think I need help? From you?
Hold it.
You're welcome.
Are you all right? Thanks for sticking up for him. People think just because of his family.
Hello, officer.
Is everything okay here?
No problem, Skip.
Mama's sending a text. Have we talked? Alright, let's go to class. Hi, Rachel. That's a nice outfit.
Oh, good. You're here.
I do beseech you, chiefly that I might set it in my prayers. What is your name?
Miranda. Oh, my father, I have broke your hest to say so.
Good. Admired Miranda, indeed worth what's dearest in the world. Many a lady I have eyed with best regard, and many a time had listened to... Many a time the harmony of their tongues hath I listened to.
Hayden, you're killing me. You've had weeks to be off book.
Sorry, Mr. Keaton.
No, don't apologize to me. Apologize to your scene partner, who's been very accommodating, and to your other fellow actors, and most of all, to yourself.
Mr. Keaton, sorry to interrupt, but does this look better? I had my mom take it in a bit.
Rachel looks awesome. This is getting as surreal as last night.
Looking good, Rach.
Very cool.
Exquisite, Rachel, as always.
Mr. Keaton, I'm still having trouble with... My affections are then most humble. I have no ambition to see a goodlier man. I mean, does she really mean that?
Especially because I just straight out told her I've been banging all the ladies.
Yeah, that is hard. We've talked about that line forever. We need a fresh perspective.
Oh boy. This is gonna go well.
The question is, are Miranda's feelings of instant passion for Ferdinand just inexperience in dramatic circumstances, or has she actually just met the love of her life? What do you think?
I feel like, on the one hand, Chloe would say Miranda's an idiot. On the other hand...
Miranda's an idiot, because falling in love is stupid. What is she, 12?
I think we both did.
Actually, she's about 15. So your point, whoever you are, about being an idiot or being naive, is well taken.
Thanks, Mr. Keaton.
Later.
See you later, guys.
Oh, no. I have first period improv with a class full of freshmen now.
Her life is hard. Yeah, same. That's kind of why I was considering the true love one, just
your
as a response to Rachel,
fabulous.
Mainly.
Where'd you get it done?
What?
Just kidding. That asshole really clocked you.
It wasn't a big deal.
I'll just be a minute.
Okay, so why am I here again?
Oh, could you grab my belt for me? I think it's in my bag over there.
Yeah, sure.
So I have a feeling that chemistry class will not be happening.
Get the belt, don't say any stupid shit, and don't, like, fall down. Should be doable, right? If I'd known acting meant getting to play with weapons, I totally would have auditioned for the Tempest.
Times
are hard for elite private high schools. Hey now, sharing is caring.
Computer, sure, let's use it.
I have feelings about this.
Oh, we already saw
most of them are not good feelings. Why do theater kids take themselves so seriously?
Yeah, Dana Ward's actually from Rachel Life is Strange as well. Ed Watson is as well. Kind of interesting, like some of these are new characters, others are pretty cool characters, I guess. This girl in her bag means she's a pirate.
Rachel looks so happy here. There's Rachel's belt. Guess I'll go give this to Rachel now.
Ara will suck as Prospera. Rachel Amber, if VC. Victoria Chase, perhaps? And any talent, maybe she would have gotten the part. Talent is that what got Esther Gate to cast you.
RA will suck as Prospera.
Oh, she's also gonna read it.
If VC had any talent, maybe she would have gotten the part.
Talent, is that what got Mr. K to cast you, slut?
Guess they don't call it Drama Lab for nothing.
Oh, I can add my own comment, sure, let's do it.
What to say? Slut shaming is so 2009. VC should know.
Right, improve that, I guess.
This poster definitely says something.
Very helpful comment, Chloe. Pepe.
Sweet collar, Pepe. Should be life is drama.
I think it's strange, actually.
Rachel Amber, drama star and guardian angel. I still can't believe that was her last night.
Note.
Sometimes you just gotta turn up the heat.
Where are all the pencils? I know it was you, Hayden!
Must be a hundred costumes in here. Am I the only student who's not in this show?
I don't know. I wonder if it's more pencil.
I'm gonna guess it's from Logan.
God. Dude, scratch your name out properly.
Dana, you are very beautiful. Do you want to go out? I would be into that. Guess who? Guess who?
Rachel? Is this your belt?
Yes! Thank you.
I really liked your costume.
Thanks.
So?
Did you bring flowers for my dressing room?
I guess I owe you.
I'll hold you to that.
I'll let you finish changing now.
Chloe Price.
Rachel Amber?
Last night was amazing.
I'd never seen Firewalk live. Pretty fierce show.
We'll have to do it again. To tell the truth, I went to bed last night wishing it never had to end. But then I thought, why? Why does it have to end?
Is that a rhetorical question?
How would you like to join me on a little field trip?
I love that the first of you is, fuck yes!
Ditch class? You mean it?
Is that weird?
No, it's awesome.
I hoped you'd say that. Now about that eye, that is a hell of a battle scar. Do you want me to cover it up with some makeup?
Ah, good battle scar.
Are you kidding? This is a badge of honor.
Respect. Let's get the hell out of here.
I love that I don't even get an option to say no to that one. It's actually really interesting the options that you get in this game for responding to things, because like, they generally tend to point in one direction, because presumably that's what Chloe wants. And back to the mill?
You sure you don't want to just grab the bus, or...?
Nope. If we're gonna go rogue, we're doing it right.
She moves real fast.
Well, what the hell am I getting into here?
Okay, well this is super cool actually.
Where does this thing go?
North? Maybe we'll end up in Seattle. Pull up a chair, Price. The view's amazing.
Elliot.
Rachel wants me to pull up a chair.
Hey, why weren't you in cam? Think okay? Yep. I'm with Drew. People were saying you were awesome. So let's talk later. Okay. Seattle. It's on the west coast, I do know that. It's sort of in the north. It's also where Max actually went for these couple of years. I think I remember that Arcadia Bay is supposed to be in Oregon, yes.
Maybe one of these crates.
Symbols.
Guess we're not the first ones to hop on this train. I wonder what the symbols mean.
That's probably like, what's its name? Like the hobo secret
Nathan's
language
dad
thing.
Is a Terminator? That totally checks out. I feel pretty confident there's going to be a dead body in here.
Wait, surprising that I can't join one. Great. Move. This will be my chair.
Thing's heavier than it looks.
Imagine if she missed and the crate just goes on the train. Fuck.
Guess I should sit down. Alright, Chloe. You're on a freaking train with Rachel freaking Amber. Play it cool.
Is this nervousness? Is that what this feeling is? Wish Max were here, so I could ask. Should I make small talk? Is that what people do?
Oh boy. What an amazing bunch of options.
It's nice Rachel we're having.
Oh my god, you got that disaster.
I need weather. It's nice weather. It sure is. So, it's kind of weird that we're hanging out.
You mean because I don't hang out with anyone and I don't have any friends?
You have friends.
Well, I used to. Friend. Singular. Her name is Max, but she left for greener, more northern pastures.
That sucks.
Hey, so, I want to say thanks.
For pulling you out of school?
No, dummy. Thanks for last night. If you hadn't shown up.
Assholes abound in Arcadia Bay.
I owe you. That's for sure.
Is that why you came along?
Are you suggesting I should need a reason to ditch school?
I bet you're wondering what we're doing.
The thought occurred, yeah.
Well, I wanted some company.
That's it?
That's it.
Try again. I'm going to need more to go on than that.
Joyrides with me aren't fun?
Joyrides to where again?
Life needs a little mystery, Chloe.
She up to.
Let's do something fun.
Agree or flirt?
V-card's been punched, Rachel. I'm sorry.
Wow.
Too far.
Well, I don't know.
Okay, something fun. I'm all ears.
Two truths and a lie.
What?
I think we should play Two Truths and a Lie. It's a game where each person offers up three facts about themselves, two of which are the truth, and one of which is...
a lie.
Right. And then the other person has to guess which is which.
Sounds fun. You're on.
I'll start. First, I'm ambidextrous. Second, I was born in New York, the land of fashion and Broadway, to which I will one day return when my heinous exile here in Arcadia Bay comes to an end.
New York, huh? I've never been.
Not a world traveler?
Not yet, at least.
If you could travel anywhere, where would you go? Russia, Greece, Kathmandu?
Kathmandu?
One day, I'm going to climb Everest.
And I thought moving away from Arcadia Bay was ambitious.
How sad knowing.
What's your third
thing? Ends up in Everest.
My third thing?
Two truths and a lie.
We're doing a thing, Rachel. Keep up, please.
Right. I'm a Leo. Meow.
Okay, so ambidextrous, born in New York, and a Leo. Gotcha.
So, which is the lie?
Hold on. Let's see if we can cheat. Do these have birth dates? Is she? Yes, she is. Does not. That's a shame. What is a lie? I'm gonna go with ambidextrous.
I don't buy the ambidextrous claim.
No? Well, that's too bad, because it's true.
Prove it. Sign your name with both hands.
Sign where? Seriously?
All the bad girls do it. Come on. Damn.
I'm afraid the lie was New York. I'm a Cali girl.
Huh. Well, you were right, 26.
So, New York's on the bucket list.
Broadway, here I come.
Cool. Okay, your turn, Price.
First fact. Right. Something about myself. Should I start things off with a lie or with the truth? Or should I cheat? Let's see how good she really is at this game.
Hmm. Well, let's start with the truth. God, the music made me throw up. I feel like the love science thing is probably not something that she would easily guess.
I love science. Seriously, I think Neil deGrasse Tyson is the shit.
Kinda huh. Cool. Kind of a smug dig on Twitter, though. There's some accounts that you should block just so that you don't get annoyed by certain people who are otherwise pretty cool. Let's see. I'm not gonna lie.
I'm secretly the lead guitarist of an all-girl Misfits cover band called The Misfits.
Impressive.
Yeah, she's gonna see right through that one. Maybe we should cheat with another lie so to make it difficult. Let's go for it.
I once broke my hand punching Stephanie Kowalski in fifth grade.
No way. Bitch took my Yoo-hoo, knocked her the fuck out. I see you like to write notes to yourself.
Helps me stay focused.
Also, sweet scar.
What scar?
You're hella mysterious, Chloe Price.
Hella.
Hella? Who says that? It's a cow.
You do, actually.
Anyway.
In the future?
I think I have your number. Okay. You say you love science, but you are failing chemistry.
You're saying failing chemistry means I hate science?
Or that Blackwell doesn't inspire your best work.
That place is a hellhole filled with shit, where shitty people go to be shitty to each other and themselves.
Tell me how you really feel, though. Anyway, school sucks, but you love science. I'm gonna say true. Now, about this broken hand story. It's not that I don't think you could knock Stephanie Kowalski out. A bitch takes your Yoo-hoo, she's gotta get caught.
Damn straight.
But you didn't get that scar from punching someone.
No.
That scar is from a distal radius fracture.
How could you possibly know that?
I broke my wrist when I was 10.
Ah.
The point is, I know that the scar you've got comes with breaking your wrist when you fall. Like, from a skateboard?
Yeah.
I guess 6 years ago?
7.
Well, shit.
I always thought I was a good liar.
Good thing you're pretty. So, let's talk about this lead guitarist business.
The business of show.
As much as I'd love to be a groupie to your all-girl cover band, The Misfits, I'm gonna have to call a lie on that one.
You don't think I can rock?
On the contrary, you absolutely rock. The problem is, your hand is smooth, no calluses. You
Sherlock
don't play
Amber.
Guitar. Pity too, you'd look hot on stage. So, if my math is correct, you cheated. You told one truth and two lies.
Maybe I just needed to test you.
Or maybe you have trust issues.
You are crazy good at this game.
A lifetime of studying the human condition.
Well, I'm impressed.
I bet it's hard to impress Chloe Price. I'm gonna feel good about that one. When your dad is the district attorney, I guess lying is something you're used to.
Seriously?
Seriously.
I know who to call if I need to get out of a ticket, then. Not that I have a right of my own. Car first, embarrassing number of moving violations second.
Hey, Thanks for trusting me.
Trusting you?
You I call it price for 18.
I guess. You opened up a lot. That's all.
It's not a big deal.
Hate to break it to you, but Chloe Price is not exactly renowned throughout Arcadia Bay as a bastion of trust and empathy.
Trust doesn't exactly come easy to me. Maybe if you'd had my life, you'd understand.
No, I got that.
Yeah, this is my first
day,
Drew.
On the other hand, I got on this train with you, didn't I?
Fair point.
Wouldn't mind listening to some music.
Well, obviously I'm gonna share with Rachel. Like, can you imagine just looking at the headphones and just being like, conversation over. It's hella cute, by the way. Sit for a while and listen to the music. Cool. Wait, move on though. Let's sleep well, 26.
Cool bracelet.
I don't actually think I'm gonna finish the episode today because it's getting pretty late.
I was a kid in Long Beach. Reminds me that there's more to experience out there than just Arcadia Bay. Maybe one day I'll go back to Long Beach. Or anywhere but here. Maybe sooner than later.
Me too. Arcadia Bay can suck a bag of dicks.
Sometimes I feel like I've got no reason to stay. Don't be surprised, Chloe, if one day I'm just out of here.
Oof.
Let me know if you need an accomplice.
Check it out! We're here! What? Where is here? Jump and find out! Did you say jump? Jump!
Alright, bad decisions. Let's do it. Yeah, I guess if you don't like Rachel in the first place, maybe you would say no to it. Seems pretty cool so far.
It's actually a pretty nice
also,
view.
Also, like, she's definitely up to something else.
And as your reward for making it up here, I have a new game for us to play.
I definitely agree that Chloe doesn't stand
like
a chance, by the way.
This is one I learned in theater class. It's all about improvisation.
So far, what I've learned about you is that you're into acting, lying, and playing games.
What's your point?
That you're either full of imagination or full of shit.
Let me know when you figure out which one. This game involves spying on people from afar. Luckily, we've got some high-tech surveillance equipment right here. Let's fire it up.
That blows.
Damn it.
Well, shit.
That was my last quarter. You?
Quarterless.
Damn.
Hey, maybe I can MacGyver something up. I've been told I'm pretty handy.
Oh yeah? Let's see what you got.
Give it a shot. First I'm gonna just give it, just look if this is where the light is. I'm like 90% certain that it's not.
Rachel really wants to use this viewfinder. I'd love to get it working.
Yeah,
for
it's
her.
Not. This is a different place. Hold on, we got a text from Mikey. Let's check that first. Hold on. What about Drew? Oh, it's his brother. Huh. Well, Mikey's nice.
Rachel's quarter is still trapped in there, waiting to be set. Huh. Looks like I might be able to pry it open with the right tool.
Right tool. Well, I guess this is not a tool.
This whole day is out of order. But in the best possible way. Damn, that's an old tree. Wait, does this sign say butt rot?
Don't see it on there. You can interact with an oak
tree.
The
lonely oak looks lonely. Guess even trees have outcasts.
Also, the spooky woman in white is behind there. You know it.
I'm thinking about prying open that viewfinder. Got a knife on you?
A knife?
Yeah. My mom took mine.
No. How about a nail file?
I guess you could stab someone with a nail file.
Oh, right.
Sure, let's try it.
Victoria, huh?
Chloe Price! Fluorine, uranium, carbon, potassium, uranium. Think I don't know the spells? Fuck you on the Baroni thing. I got a troll for it. You covered uranium, nitrogen, then.
You called me a Kunston, huh? It is SM.
Fuck you, British!
I love Victoria's rage texts. You get them as Max as well. Yeah, the texts are great just in general, but Victoria is always just raging at them.
So easy in the movies. Wonder if I can find something sturdier to use.
I mean, it'd be rocks. There's actually some here.
Looks like this one might actually be working.
I guess we could also just find a quarter.
Was this how historic axe murderers searched for their next victim?
That's graffiti, that shit, then. Yeah, the Victoria texts are great. Victoria says it's such
axe,
a salt pillar.
Don't fell.
Alright, so things we need to find. History placard.
This Blackwall guy sure liked founding stuff that was already there. Founders keepers, I guess.
That's what we call Columbusing. Let's see. I don't get an...
I don't want to head down there just yet.
Alright. I don't get any interactions on any of the stones, so I assume it's not a stone that I'm looking for. Oh wait, maybe actually, can I, like, get his sextant? Guess not.
I'm gonna need a bigger prior majigger.
Also, I can just sit down.
Just a day in the park with Rachel Amber.
Still looking for a tool. Guess that's
if Max were here, she'd probably take a black and white photograph and call it Innocence Lost or some shit.
I'm not gonna scare
I guess
squirrels.
Nature doesn't quite provide.
Cute. Ooh, yeah, sure. Get that. You have to throw the nail file away. I imagine Rachel wants that back.
Stealing a dedication plate takes persistence.
Let's see what Steph has to say.
Oh no!
That's good. I like that. I really like Steph and Mikey both. They were super nice. Although Steph is a killer GM. Right, it's not Rachel I should talk to. I should talk to the viewfinder.
Prescott, power activate.
Finally!
I don't want to boast, so I'll let you do it for me.
Chloe Price, you are truly the Viewfinder Whisperer. I stand in awe of your powers.
Rachel smells like jasmine. Is she smelling me right now too?
Oh, Chloe.
Really should have showered this morning.
All right, here's the game. You find some people for us to spy on, and then you and I will act out what they're saying and thinking.
That's it. I do that in my head during like every class.
Pretty
See?
Fun game.
You're a natural. Let's give it a try.
Real. I guess that's not.
Hey,
what
do you
there.
Say we barbecue some squirrels when we're done here?
God, you just have the best ideas.
Apparently, the woman in white. Oh, there's this guy who has
Loving
an awkward run cycle.
What's he thinking right now?
No matter how fast I go, I'll never outwalk this wedgie.
That's so tragic, but also beautiful in its own way.
Sweet beanie.
What do you suppose she's thinking?
Nature's Wi-Fi sucks.
Maybe there's a squirrel family around here with broadband.
If only I can guess their password. We love nuts, 69.
Dingoes ate our babies, 13.
Too soon.
Grilled that. Best name ever.
What's going on with these two?
And the Lord saideth, thou shalt make a burnt offering of your firstborn son.
Who are you talking to, Dad?
No one, son. Now, lean into the grill and see if the fire started.
Further.
Further.
Wow.
That was dark. Too dark. Perfect dark.
This is fun. Who's next? Oh, sorry. Didn't mean to hog the viewfinder. Jackpot. Commence makeout session in 3, 2, 1. Nailed it. Damn, they are really going at it.
Oh, honey. I think we used the vibrating bed for too long. I'm totally seeing double.
Rachel?
Hmm.
Hey, are you all right?
What are we doing?
Excuse me?
Last I checked, you're supposed to be Chloe Price. Yet we've been ditching now for
name.
Hours, and we haven't even gotten wasted yet. That's got to be against some school ditching rule.
I don't know. I might still be hungover from last night.
Wrong answer. You don't ask a girl out and then not buy her a drink.
She definitely knows those people.
They have a bottle of wine.
Well, they seem kind of old. At least the guy, okay. I don't know about the woman, actually.
Or we could go try to find a liquor store instead.
No. You shouldn't bring alcohol to a public park if you're not willing to share it with everybody, right? And fuck it. I just want to take something that's not mine. All right. I'm going in. Try to keep up.
Mistake and Judge Rachel. Thanks for the warning.
Can we help you?
But I guess don't spoil.
Oh my god!
Okay. Going for subtlety here, I guess.
Holy shit. Talk about committing to a performance. Better act fast.
We don't be hung up on the bus, please?
What?
Whoops. Hi.
Oh, thank god. Please, this girl is in trouble. Go get help.
Help Rachel.
I need to get these two to focus on Rachel so I can swipe the wine.
What are you waiting for? Go! I already called 911. They should have an ambulance here any moment. In the meantime, they said to keep close watch on her. Like, turn all the way around and really focus.
Little Chloe.
Watch out. I'm going to check her pulse. That's on her neck, right?
I still think you should go get help. There's a ranger station on the other side of the park.
Good point. We'll keep watch while you go.
Look at all the time we've wasted already. This woman needs mouth-to-mouth resuscitation. Stat.
No.
Yep. Definitely needs mouth-to-mouth.
Okay. Okay. You can do this. I can't do it.
Pathetic.
Look, he's clearly useless. This woman needs help from someone who actually knows what they're doing. Okay, fine. I'm going. But
I was kind of expecting
show up,
her to
I hope they
volunteer
don't
for the mouth-to-mouth
arrest
next.
Us? Good Samaritan law. Ever heard of it? It means you have to do everything in your power to help someone in trouble. Everything.
God, oh, I get you mean.
I'm going in.
Yeah, it makes sense. I mean, I actually like how deep the characters are in this series a lot. Sorry, Rachel.
Hey, wow. I'm all better now. You saved my life. From the bottom of my heart. Thank you.
Yeah. Good work, everyone. Peace out.
Booth.
That was incredible.
You're a hero.
I guess I am.
Here. You earned this.
Sure.
Thanks. I could use a drink after trying to keep up with you.
I am excessively sober right now.
Right. Okay. Guess we're leaving now.
Yeah, interesting that you mentioned a VA, because I have completely forgotten, actually, that Chloe has a new VA in this one. But yeah, I was super bummed when I read that, because I thought Ashley Burch did such a good job with her, but yeah, new one is actually getting it. I don't know her name. get your food stuck else again, please?
Whoa. Hey, check this out. What?
Oh shit, it's a junkyard. Log for lease.
Pile of trash.
Yeah. An awesome pile of trash.
Let's explore.
You have fun, Chloe.
I'm gonna go sit down.
Rachel's been acting kind of standoffish ever since we left the park. What's her deal?
I've heard that actors are moody, but wow, Rachel.
I'm not moody. I just need some space. Is that all right with you?
Okay. Actually, no. I thought we were having a great day together. Why are you acting like this all of a sudden?
I'm not acting like anything. I just want to be left alone right now.
Yeah, I get it. I know I'm not the easiest person to be around. I don't exactly have tons of experience with the whole friendship thing.
Not everything revolves around you, Chloe.
I didn't say it did. I'm just saying I understand.
No, you really don't.
Fuck! Okay.
Oh, she's super upset about it.
I have no idea what's going on with Rachel, but apparently, she gets smashy when she's angry.
I imagine.
I can remember.
Surely the woman was cheating on her? The guy looked way too old for her.
Score. Hey, check it out. I don't always drink beer, but when I do, I prefer drinking it next to an old toilet.
Die, stupid bottles! Ow.
Home run!
The big hit.
Can I see?
Sure.
I asked you to leave me alone.
Are you kidding me? I know you're the school princess and all, with the DA daddy and the perfect grades and all the perfect little Victoria Chases kissing your perfect ass, but seriously, fuck you.
Great. I'm leaving. See you around, Chloe.
You can't leave!
Watch me.
Rachel, wait! Don't go. Why not? Because I don't want to ruin this the way I ruin everything else in my life. And what is this exactly? I mean, fuck. Are you actually going to make me say it?
Say what exactly?
You know, like a friendship, but more.
Ah. I know. Weird, right?
It's just, today was the best day I've had since my dad died. And when I almost ruined it just now, the way I ruin everything, it made me realize whatever's going on between us is special. Come on, say something.
Chloe,
you know what? Forget it. This was really stupid. I mean, you're Rachel Amber, and I'm Chloe Price.
It's not that. It's just hard right now. And I can't talk about it.
Why not?
Because I can't. I know it isn't fair, but it's how it is. Goodbye, Chloe.
Poor Chloe, just in general.
Fuck this place.
Alright, that's special shit. Oh. That's a good range of options there. Storytelling that they're doing with her, with Chloe not responding to any of these. It's just everything in the game has so much story behind it, it's great.
You know she's fake. You can't take your eyes off her. Who else do I know who fits that description? Yeah! Fuck off, Rachel.
Look so junk.
I've never understood your hard-on for cameras, Max. You took a million pictures of us, and not one of them showed that you were gonna leave when I needed you most. Fuck cameras.
David, take this one.
If you want to rip a family apart from the inside, it's important to bring the proper tools. Fuck you, David.
Wait a minute, is that her truck? Like, in the future? It totally is.
Dad.
Oh. There's a bloodstain there, that's the worst, man.
Thank you.
Not again. Mark, been to enough yet?
I just called to tell you that I miss you, my old friend.
Why are you crying, sweetheart?
Because you're not real.
I'm not.
What is going on? What's past is prologue and shit.
Kiddo, look on the bright side, would ya?
What bright side?
You made a new friend today.
Where's my marker?
Oh.
Oh. There it is.
Gotta say, that was some fight. A lover's quarrel, you might say? She nearly took your head off.
What do you care?
Sorry, sweetheart. I guess I'm getting into your personal business.
I guess I did that?
Sometimes people need you, though. Even when they don't admit it.
He feels for Chloe right now. Seems to be some kind of public animal in the game, like the doe was in. Maybe of her dad, actually, because the doe was kind of symbolic of Rachel, like in Life is Strange.
You came. I'm glad. Hey. I
couldn't let the day end with whatever this afternoon was.
Chloe, I want to talk to you about something, but I don't know how to talk about this.
You don't have to tell me anything you don't want to.
You remember that guy that we saw under this tree with that woman?
The ones who were making out?
That was my dad.
Oh.
Oh.
All right.
Ah, yeah.
And that woman...
That explains it.
...was definitely not my mom.
Oh.
The worst part is... I'm not surprised. I felt like my dad's been lying about something for a while. I didn't know what it was. So when I saw he got a text from an unknown number asking him to meet, I thought I could catch him or something.
Ah.
I'm so sorry, Rachel. I don't know what to say.
Neither do I. Chloe, I love my dad. I love him. And I never want to see his fucking face again.
When my dad died, I was so mad at him. For months, I felt wrong because half the time I thought of him, I wanted to scream. And the other half, I forgot.
Forgot that anything had changed. It's silly, but I've carried this photo around with me for years. It's from Mount Hood. My dad took me hiking there when I was 10, and it started raining, and I fell and broke my arm 3 miles from the car. I remember screaming like I was gonna die, but my dad, he carried me down the mountain. I still remember the smell of his coat and how calm he was and the sound of his voice and... He was just so strong, you know? I felt safe.
You trusted him?
Completely.
Here.
Chloe, I owe you an apology.
Don't worry about it.
No, I mean it. Whatever's going on between us, it's intense and new and awesome, and you had the courage to tell me that you feel it too. And I treated you like shit.
Courage? I don't know if I'd call it that. More like blind desperation. And maybe a slight buzz from that wine.
I just want you to know... I'm lucky that you were with me today. You're a badass, Chloe Price.
What?
Remember that biker asshole who wouldn't let you into the mill? You talked your way right past him.
You saw that?
And those skeevy douchebags who followed you upstairs? You dropped that one guy with a bottle to the face.
Only because you showed up at the last minute and...
What about Drew? When he was picking on Nathan? You got right in his face and called him out.
That was pretty sweet, actually.
I totally kicked ass in
the knee. See? You're the real thing, Chloe. I don't know anyone like you. Plus, you came along with me, no questions asked.
Well, I don't really need a good reason to ditch school.
I guess tomorrow there'll be hell to pay.
My mom might skip grounding and just go straight to the death penalty.
And my dad will definitely punish me with...
Fuck your dad.
Fuck him.
What I wouldn't give to leave this place and never look back.
What's stopping us?
Us? Are you serious?
There's nothing keeping me here. Not anymore.
So, if I came to you tomorrow and told you to pack your bags...
I'm serious. Let's do it, Chloe. Let's leave this place forever. Okay. Can I borrow your lighter? Thank you.
Just started the forest fire. Looks like the end of the episode, and that was great. That was, just very good, basically. Very cute, very lots of feels. Wow, like there at the end, the Joker, that really actually got to me. Also, does Rachel have either fire or wind powers? Kind of look like that way. Okay, well, don't tell me what happens on that. Because I wanna figure out. Is that her dad? Yeah, that definitely looked like him. Who is this? Because. Looks like there's a lot of focus on her specifically as well. But she's probably not some random woman. Yeah, that was. Wow, that was great. I mean, oh wait, we might not be quite done yet. No, we're done, okay. Yeah, that was, wow. So I actually, like I said, before I went on this, I actually replayed Life is Strange, and man, what a ride that was. And like, that definitely reminded me just how great Chloe is as a character. Like, I remember when I first played it, I was just like, basically immediately I thought she was awesome, and then like, I mean, in a way, she's kind of already the main character of Life is Strange, even though you are obviously playing as Max. But like, there's so much of the story is about Chloe and about how she, and like about her, family, about, you know, it's via Chloe that Max gets mixed up in all that business, basically. And of course, like, the story is also very much about Max's feelings for Chloe, and you know, yeah. So it's definitely fun to play as her instead. Especially considering she's, you know, even more broke. It's, man, considering that, it's, okay, so it's not actually, gonna be in the letter. That's interesting. Well, I'll see what I make of that when I play the later episodes, I guess. Okay, but yeah, I was just talking about Chloe, and like, now that I think about it, it's super sad to think that a couple years after this, she's, like, Rachel's gonna get murdered by a piece of shit Jefferson. And, like, poor fucking Chloe is all I can say. Oh, wow, yeah, like you mentioned, she actually did write it. That's super cool. Even if she couldn't, like, voice it because of the strike, which, by the way, super respect to her. Like, you never cross a picket line. Not even, I guess, to play in the Don't Starve. Don't Starve. What am I saying? Life is Strange prequel. Oh, wait, Chloe writes Ashley Burch and Rihanna De Vries. Are there flashback lines or something? Like flash forward lines? They would have had it from her. Anyway, I guess everyone here also just like congratulations, because you people did really amazing work. And by the way, I was actually looking up the donuts the other day, and like what is super interesting, what I had no idea is remember me? Like I played that game a year or something ago on stream, and like it was kind of bad. Like it had some good ideas, but like ultimately it was bad, and I didn't enjoy it much, and eventually I actually just couldn't get through it because the controls were so bad. That was made by the same people who did the Life is Strange. That was their first game. It's like, that just blew my mind, because it's like, wow, that's night and day. And it's also just like, that's actually super motivational when you think about it, because like, yeah, the first thing you make might suck, but then like you learn from failure and you make something so good as this. Like, actually, like, it's not just the studio, it's like several of the same people worked in both games. Like, that's so weird to think about, that like, the same people who did Remember Me did Life is Strange. Like, failure is the best teacher. Okay, well, I was talking about Life is Strange specifically, not about Before the Storm, but like, so is this one actually done by the same people? Because I wasn't paying much attention aside from the actors, I guess. I mean, I guess I'll look that up later as well. Right, anyway, I think I'm kind of done talking, so let's skip the rest of the credits. Alright. This is always fun to see. So most people attacked. Wow, I wasn't expecting so many people to defend Nathan, considering, you know, what a piece of shit he is in Life is Strange, even if, you know, there's obviously reasons for it, like his dad is an abusive asshole and like Jefferson and all that, but like, yeah. Anyway. Pretty even. You can actually purchase both from Frank, I guess. I mean, I did steal the money, so I could have done it actually. I actually didn't do this one because I thought, like, Mom probably feels very bad looking at pictures of him, considering they're all gone. Wow, only 6% did that. I mean, I guess she would first of all need to actually notice the option. Let's see. Gibbs demo. Security guard. I missed that. That was that Victoria's homework was kind of mean, but it's, on the other hand, it's like, deserve it so much. 2% of people didn't share earbuds with Rachel. Just the idea of Chloe just plugging them in, like, all right, I'm done with you. Don't want to talk anymore. So funny. I wonder what happens if you don't jump out of the train. I guess, like, same with getting past the bouncer in the beginning, like, you just skip that part of the story? I could kind of see the intro being skipped. Like, I guess the story would still work because, like, you still know Rachel. Cool. Meet her on school, I guess. But, like, not jumping out of a train. I feel like that kind of messes up the entire story. So maybe she just, like, drags you along or something. Anyway. Ooh, preview.
Shit.
No one steals from me.
Fuck.
I want my fucking money!
Oh, mistakes were made. No, we're not gonna start the next episode right now because it's late. So we're gonna continue this next time, which might be tomorrow. I'm not sure, certain yet. If it's not tomorrow, I think I have something I'm doing Saturday evening, so then it would probably be Sunday. Anyway, if you wanna catch the next stream, consider following the channel or follow me on Twitter at MagisterMistex or joining the Discord, because that's where I announce future streams. Either way, thanks for watching. So, as I go back to the main menu, I notice that it's on fire now. So that's super rad. Thanks for watching.